Hi, Teresa Momber here, and I'll be showing you how to make this card in today's video. Trim a piece of white cardstock to 3¼ by 4½ inches and begin sponging yellow ink in the center of the cardstock. Switch to orange ink and continue sponging on the lower portion. Cut a mask using Spellbinder's Classic Circles large die templates. Then place in the center of your cardstock. Sponge again, this time using pink ink, working around the mask. Then switch to sponging along the sides of the cardstock and work your way in. Remove the mask and position it lower to mask for the reflection of the sun in the water. Then, sponge around the bottom of the mask only using pink ink. Remove the mask again. And now, sponge around all the edges using a darker pink. Switch back to orange ink and add a little more color, sponging lightly across the horizon line. Place sticky notes across the horizon line to mask for the sky, and then sponge once again using orange ink. Reposition the mask to cover the bottom section, and then begin sponging once again using orange ink. Switch to pink ink and sponge a little more along the horizon line. Remove the mask and then use Copic marker RV13 to add some lines into the ocean to look like waves. Switch to Copic marker YR02 and add more lines. Then use an opaque white gel pen to add white lines onto some of the darker lines to look like white caps. Next, using the palm fronds from the Tropical Nature stamp set from Gina K. Designs, stamp using dark olive ink. Using the palm tree image, also from Tropical Nature, stamp using dark olive ink. Color in the tree trunks using Copic marker YG99. And use Copic marker YG95 to fill in the palm fronds. With the background set aside, stamp the plumeria flower, also from the Tropical Nature stamp set, using Memento Tuxedo Black ink. Begin by coloring the centers of the flowers with Copic marker Y17. Blend out from there with Copic marker YR02. Switch to Copic marker YR000 and fill in the petals the rest of the way, leaving just a small highlighted area uncolored on each petal. Use YR12 to deepen the shadow along each shade line on the petals. For the foliage, start with Copic marker YG99. Fill in the remaining area with YG05. And then color over the entire area with YG93 to tone down the brightness just a bit. After coloring, cut out the image using scissors. Trim black cardstock to slightly larger than your background and adhere. Then adhere both layers to a 4.25 by 5.5 inch tan card base. Adhere the cutout flower to the lower left-hand corner of your card. Then use scissors to trim away the portions that extend over the edge. And that completes our card project. Thanks for watching.